Hey everyone, and welcome back to My Stenohood. If you're new here, my name is Edna, and in this channel, we talk about all things steno, including tips for students, as well as my journey as a court reporting student. So if you're interested in content like this, please consider subscribing. So I wanted to start off this video by thanking all of you who messaged me on all of my platforms, on Twitter, on Instagram, on Facebook, and here on YouTube. This week has been a little bit rough, and I'll get to it in a minute, but because of all of your words of encouragement and all of your support, it got me through this week. I have a lot to tell you guys, and let's just get started. All right, so let's start off with Monday. Let's not talk about Monday. You guys already know how my Mondays are. My Mondays are the best. I look forward to every Monday. And this Monday was just like the other Mondays. It was great. I went to school. My fingers were cooperating, blah, blah, blah. Good old Monday. Tuesdays are definitely jinxed. So this Tuesday, I told you guys I have a lot to tell you. I get tension headaches, and I never had any type of headache like this in my life prior to being in court reporting school. So if you don't know what I'm talking about, when I'm typing and the more I type or the more I write on my machine, I get tension buildup. Whatever's going on in my life, plus physically, when you're on the machine, I get super tense, especially when I'm gonna take a test. So on Tuesday, I woke up with a really bad tension headache. And I don't know if you guys have felt something like this before, because I certainly had never felt anything like that before until I started court reporting school. And so what I've been trying to do now is stretch. So I've been trying to do a few stretches before I get on my machine. So there's a lot of videos that you guys can find online, which is what I did, to see how I can release a lot of that tension that builds up over time. And so hopefully that is going to help me to heal all the tension that gets built up throughout the weeks, the days, and so on. So because of my tension headache, I didn't go to school on Tuesday, which is totally fine. As you guys can see, I'm not a perfect student, and I do have a lot going on, as many of you can probably relate, and every once in a while, I'm gonna have to miss school. So this Tuesday, I didn't go to school and I had to allow my body to heal. If you guys have any type of body ache, please let me know in the comments what you do to help you release some of that tension or help you relax or deal with all of the stress that court reporting school puts on our bodies. So let me know in the comments. I'm very interested to find out what all of you guys do to deal with all of this. It just goes to show how intense court reporting school is. And I just wanna put it all out there, so if you guys can relate, you guys can tell me in the comments what you do to kind of meditate or relax, soothe, if you have a routine of getting a massage to help with all of that tension or body aches. So let me know in the comments what you guys do to help with maintaining your body in top shape and helping you get through this program. Okay, so Wednesday came around. I went back to school, and remember, Wednesdays and Thursdays we take a test. So on Wednesday, I wasn't prepared to take a test because I already passed that particular test last week, which is good because I had come back from being sick, so I wasn't 100% on Wednesday. But I still went to class, I still did everything that I was supposed to do. On Thursday, I really had to focus because I really wanted to get my Q&A test for 130 words a minute. So I currently don't have a routine that I do every time I take a test. So I do try to talk to myself and try to calm myself down before a test, because I used to get very anxious about it and thinking that it was, you know, life or death situation if I didn't pass the test. So I have tried to talk to myself and try to relax before I take a test. But this week was very different. This week, And I really want to thank you guys for following me on this journey, because you guys really help me and you have no idea how much you guys help me. We hear this over and over and over. You have to practice, you have to practice, you have to practice. If you don't practice, you're not gonna progress. If you don't practice, you're not gonna pass a test and you're not gonna keep moving forward. So I just said to myself, you're gonna take this test and you're gonna grade it no matter what happens. And when it was over, I said to myself, oh my God, I think I just passed this test. So I thought, oh my gosh, either I really nailed this test or I was in such a zone that I thought I passed the test and maybe I didn't write anything. Then I was thinking, oh my goodness. And I was shaking. Like as soon as the test was over, I was just shaking. And it was like all this adrenaline was going through my body and I printed it out. I turned it in. I really want to know if I pass this test or not. It's going to kill me if I have to wait another day to find out. So I went back to school that night and I transcribed my notes. And so this week, my update is that I passed my 130 words per minute Q&A. It's amazing. So that means that last week I passed my lit. This week I passed my Q&A. So next week, I'm really gonna try to aim for that last Q&A that I need in order to pass that speed. So that would be super amazing. You know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna practice, and that's what we have to do. We just have to continue practicing no matter what. No matter if you pass a test or don't pass a test, keep practicing. I know it sounds like a broken record, and I know we wanna say, like, when is this gonna finish? When are we going to end this whole practice thing? But it never ends. So anyway, that's my update for this week. Thank you guys so much for following me along. Remember to give me a thumbs up if you want me to continue making these weekly updates so that you guys can follow my progress. And as always, thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.